Major General Sir Clive Selwyn Steele, September 30, 1892 to August 5, 1955, was an engineer and a senior officer of the Australian Army who served in both the First and Second World Wars. He was instrumental in the expansion of the Royal Australian Engineers, RAE, in preparation for the war against Japan. Born on September 30, 1892 at Canterbury, Melbourne, the son of Herbert Selwyn Steele and Alice Lydia Nay Sinclair, Clive was educated at Scotch College, Prefect and Captain of Boats, 1910, and the University of Melbourne, BCE 1919. He joined the militia in 1912. Appointed as a second lieutenant in the Royal Australian Engineers, RAE, Australian Imperial Force on October 8, 1915, he sailed for Egypt in November with the 5th Field Company. Arriving on the Western Front in March 1916, he was promoted to captain in September. While on recreation leave, he married Amy Iceland Bilson on January 6, 1917 at West Brompton, London. During actions around Peronne, France in August 1918, he commanded a unit undertaking repairs to bridges while under artillery and machine gun fire. On August 31, he undertook reconnaissance 200 yards, 180 m, in front of the Australian lines, providing details of the state of bridges across the River Somme and the Somme Canal. For this action, he was awarded the Military Cross. He was promoted to Major in October. Arriving back in Australia, he was discharged on August 1, 1919. Finishing his engineering degree at Melbourne University in 1919, he gained employment with Australian Reinforced Concrete and Engineering Company until 1921 and then with James Hardy and Company Proprietary Ltd. from 1921 to 1923. Setting up private practice in 1924 as a consulting engineer, he designed and supervised structural works including the State Savings Bank of Victoria Building in Melbourne, the Members Stand at Flemington Racecourse, the National Mutual Life Association of Australasia Ltd. building in Brisbane, Her Majesty's Theatre, Sydney, and the Melbourne Town Hall. From 1919, he had continued to serve in the militia. In 1926, he was promoted to Lieutenant Colonel and appointed to command the 4th Divisional Engineers, 1926 to 1931, and the 14th Battalion, 1933 to 1939. With the outbreak of the Second World War, Steele was seconded to the 2nd Australian Imperial Force on October 13, 1939 as the commander of the 6th Divisional Engineers. He was promoted to temporary brigadier and appointed chief engineer of I Corps in April 1940. He sailed for the Middle East in September and during the Greek campaign in April 1941. He was chief engineer of the Anzac Corps. During the withdrawal at Pharsalia on April 18, despite attacks by German aircraft, he organized the filling of a bomb crater in the road which was impeding the withdrawal of the Allied forces. He was awarded the Distinguished Service Order and the Greek War Cross, and was twice mentioned in dispatches for his service in the Middle East. Transported to Java, Netherlands East Indies in January 1942, he was then sent to Sumatra on February 14, where he helped organize the evacuation of Allied troops from Oost Haven. He returned to Australia in March, and in April was promoted to temporary Major General and appointed Engineer-in-Chief at Land Headquarters, Melbourne. In preparation for the war against Japan, he established the RAE Training Centre at Kapooka, New South Wales, and increased the size of the School of Military Engineering at Liverpool, which trained sappers who disarmed mines, demolished obstacles, provided water supplies and other services to military camps, cut and milled timber, built huts, roads, bridges, railways, airfields, and wharves, and operated the Army's water transport vessels. With the reorganization of Land Headquarters in October 1943, fortifications, works, engineer stores and transport were added to Steele's responsibilities. During 1944 or 1945, he personally designed the heavy lift ship Crusader. On March 12, 1946, he transferred to the Reserve of Officers. Steele had been awarded the W.C. Cournot Medal for 1944 by the University of Melbourne. He was active in the Institution of Engineers, Australia, and was appointed Knight Commander of the Order of the British Empire, KBE, in 1953. He died of myocardial infarction on August 5, 1955 at the Repatriation General Hospital, Heidelberg, and was cremated. He was survived by his wife. The couple were childless. Steele Barracks, the current home of the School of Military Engineering, is named in Sir Clive Steele's honor. == References